All 36 localities in Maguindanao have received ballots, voters' lists, and other election paraphernalia to be used in the province-wide plebiscite this Saturday. Local election officers and treasurers will now segregate them by their clustered precincts. Unlike the national polls, voting centers for the plebiscite will be open for only 8 hours. The votes will be counted manually. The provincial election supervisor believes that with only one issue and two choices at stake, the result of the plebiscite could be out by noon the following day.
Number at saka yung inwards, i-check namin, and then magtatali kami. Kung mag-umpisa kami at 8 o'clock, baka kung nandun na lahat yan, matapos namin yan mga 11. Nakamatagal na yan, 12. Basta nandun na yung 36.
Banners around Maguindanao encourage voters to pick yes to the law dividing the province into Maguindanao del Norte and Maguindanao del Sur. But for the locally based Interfaith Movement for Peaceful and Clean Elections, or IM4Peace, residents were not given enough time to scrutinize the proposed split and make an informed vote. The group urged the Commission on Elections earlier this month to postpone the plebiscite by 2 more months. But the COMELEC says the issue is nothing new to residents who have seen Maguindanao already split before, only to be overturned by the Supreme Court.
So tingin namin, yung hinihingi nila na 2 months, what for? Kung information, alam naman yan eh. Alam na alam ng tao yan. Kung sabi nila, ano, preparasyon, anong kailangan i-prepare? Ready naman kami.
The group is doing its own information campaign and plans instead to focus on preparing its volunteers to monitor the polls for any irregularities. Meanwhile, the Parish Pastoral Council for Responsible Voting, which is the COMELEC citizen arm, will put up voters' assistance desks. Over 1,000 personnel from the Bangsamoro Police have been deployed to the plebiscite. At least 2 police personnel will be stationed per voting center. But for the police regional director, this election will not be as volatile as previous national polls, where areas of Maguindanao have usually been tagged as hotspots.
Regardless kasi kung how ready we are, there are still possibilities. And it's although it is very remote, but then we are prepared for any eventualities.
As far as the national poll body is concerned, it's all systems go. And they will be in Maguindanao to observe the vote, which will cost the local government nearly 90 million pesos.
Beginning Friday until the plebiscite day on Saturday, any form of campaigning for or against dividing the province will be prohibited. But the civil society group IM4Peace continues to appeal to Maguindanaoans to think and discuss for themselves the impact of a vote that will affect their future. Anjo Bagawisan, ABS-CBN News, Maguindanao.